Johnny Puakea. One of the questions I've got to ask you, Outrigger seems to be exploding on the East Coast.
Yeah.
Does that surprise you?
Not really. I mean, we always saw the East Coast, especially Florida, as a great place to paddle outriggers. And it could be a hotbed for outrigger paddling because of the weather and the inlets and the calm water if you wanted, rougher water if you go outside. I think the Standup is starting to make a push to the outriggers because so many more people are actually getting on the water and then they're getting exposed to a different craft that they like. So I think really making it take off.
Talk a little bit about how paddling Standup and paddling outrigger go hand in hand or can really complement each other.
Oh, absolutely. I think Standup is a lot of resistance on your body. It's because of the length of the shaft and the boards aren't as fast as the outrigger. The outrigger gives you, to me, a better feel, more speed, which is why a lot of people are liking it. They get off a Standup and like, wow, this thing's really quick. I'm going to give this a shot. And it's a little less taxing on your body. So I know Danny, when he trains, there's Standup and there's a lot of outrigger. A lot of times it's more outrigger than there is Standup for his training because of how easier it is on your body. Plus you learn this feel in the water of more speed. And I think if you learn this feel of more speed in the water and you get used to that, no matter what craft you get on, you try to match that speed again. So your body's used to going, okay, this is the speed through the water. When I put it into here and come out here, this is how long it's supposed to take. Your body says that. And you get in a boat or something that's slower or whatever it is and you go, oh, come on, it's supposed to be there. And I think you push yourself a little harder to look for that speed. It may hurt more the next day, but I think that happens. I think it helps a lot in that way.
Any thoughts, tips, whatever you want to call it, for folks that are thinking about trying outrigger but might be a little bit, I don't know if I should do this?
I encourage it because they're faster. And a lot of people, that's fun. You know, it catches the wave easier, it rides the wave a little bit longer. It's faster in the flat. And I think it's a sensitive craft. So you learn to be a little more efficient on your paddling. And if you're a little bit too much on one side or rough, you can flip over. So I think it's good. It's very and it's challenging for people. I think it's good. Yeah.
Is the sort of increase in popularity, particularly across the country, influencing what you're thinking about in terms of new designs?
Not really. I mean, I have some ideas for some new designs, which I kind of always do, you know, and we're playing with some new things right now. But I don't see, as far as outriggers go, I don't see influence of beginners or experienced people really affecting the design itself.
So what does influence you when you're thinking about those new designs?
Speed. Speed, stability, how comfortable you are in it, you know, how can we make this a little more comfortable? How can we make it a little more stable without slowing it down? How can we gain more speed on a wave? Like, where's our volume at? Things like that. How can I get a little more run off of each bump? What do I do with my rocker? What do I change to get this? Always looking for a little bit, and every once in a while we'll go way outside the box and give something a try. Which I tend to do now.
Anything else you want to talk about?
No, I want to thank you guys for doing such a good job of supporting everybody here and getting info out, and it's always fun.